is sponsored in management by Farooq College. The biggest differential was a Xavier Institution and the Calicut University. And it enjoys distinction of being the most advanced co-education minority education institution in South India, offering instructions at undergraduate and postgraduate levels, and guidance and research in specialized fields. In recognition of its superior status in the field of higher education, Farooq College has been granted autonomous status by UGC and our Jayakumar. We have with us today, respected K. Jayakumar sir, Honorable Vice Chancellor of Malad University. He is a well-known educationist and literary figure. After a successful career in the Indian administrative service, holding various key positions, including district at the Kozhikode, he retired as a chief secretary of Government of Kerala. And after his retirement, he was chosen as the first vice chancellor of Indian Heritage and Malayalam University. Highly regarded career. One thing I would like to mention, a successful manager should also be a good citizen. You have built strong cultural roots in you. You have had personality, honesty, integrity, hard work, foresight, and ability to take people along are an important young man and your management degree. You must give respect to your parents and teachers who have sheltered, looked after them, taken care of. I don't want to prolong my speech. I conclude extending you all best wishes. My humbly bless you for a meritorious success in your studies, examination, and positive career and future. Thank you very much.
Chairman of FIMS, Shri Jayakumar, my old-time friend and esteemed friend, Shri C.P. Mohammed, Shri Kelly Dabat Goya, and Shri Sati Kuriakos, distinguished faculty, and my dear students. I was fairly mentally prepared to talk to you about a few things which a management student should know. But then you made me very, should I say, not emotional, but nostalgic by presenting all these 6 minutes capsule, where you took me through a sort of a hurried walkthrough through my life. After seeing that film, the abiding message which I got was how life has made a young man into an old man. Somebody with a lot of hair with very little hair. All those physical changes could be very, because one doesn't look at old photographs that frequently. So you gave me an opportunity to look at my old photographs. Many of these photographs are not with me. I congratulate Farooq College's management and this Farooq Institute of Management Studies for pursuing high levels of excellence in management education. This is not the first time that I come here, although this is the first time I come to the Management Institute. I've been to this very same hall a few months ago to release a book written by a blind teacher here, which was also a very heartbreaking event. And Farooq Institution, or college, is nothing new to me. I've been in Calicut for long years, and my association with all these great people dates back to a few decades. I was district collector Calicut as early as in 1986, and left Calicut in 88 or 89. It's long since I left Calicut, but my emotional attachment to Calicut still remains, still is as intact as it used to be. With your chairman, Mr. P.K. Ahmed, I think I became sub-collector in Calicut in 1980. and he was my co-traveler in the flight from Delhi to Cochin. As I was completing my IAS training in the last lap and coming to Cochin and driving to Calicut HR, we were on the same flight, and I said I didn't know him earlier, but that is the day on which I met him before I entered Calicut as a sub-collector in 1980 and subsequently as collector in 1986. So these personal relationships are very strong and very old, and I'm sure it will continue till the end of our lives. Ultimately, success is a very personal definition. Success is a personal definition. Unfortunately, we are guided by the criteria or definition of success given to us by others. Students and most of us do not invent our own formula or a definition of success. What is success? A success means successful. If you are successful, you are successful if you are absorbed in a multinational, MNC. If an MNC comes and takes you, you are successful. If your salary is much more than what others get, you are successful. If you are sent to the United States for training for 2 years, you are successful. If you get a lot of money and you are able to take your family for a holiday to Switzerland every 6 months, you are successful. If you are driving a huge car costing 2 crores of rupees, you are successful. It's all good. I am not saying that you should travel only in an auto rickshaw. You travel in as big car as possible you can afford. But these are only facilitating factors to make you happy. And if you are not happy, your success has no meaning. Success without ethics, excellence without ethics, success without truth, success without sacrifice, all these things have eroded the value and the sheen of your success. You might be saying that you studied in such and such institution, you are an excellent person, you pursue excellence in anything, everything you do, but if there is no ethics as the underpinning of your success will be corrupt. It will be hollow. Therefore, espousal of ethics is something very important. Then, our success doesn't happen in a vacuum. Any business enterprise which you are going to guide or which you are going to become part of doesn't exist in a vacuum. Many successful people think that they exist in a vacuum. That is why the rich necessarily becomes anti-poor. Why should the rich necessarily become anti-poor? You don't have to be anti-poor to become rich, or you don't have to be anti-poor just because you are rich. How can your richness and the poverty and the poorness, if there is a word like that, exist in a world? How do you compromise? What I said was, your business enterprise does not exist in a vacuum. If only the society has buying power, if only society is contented, if only society provides the kind of atmosphere by which your business enterprise thrives, if only there is social harmony, then only your business enterprise will thrive. You cannot go and invest in Libya today. If you have a lot of money, you are not going to invest in Syria today. You are not going to invest in Yemen today. Nobody will do it. Why? Because the society is restless, is in turmoil. What does that mean? Social contentedness, social harmony is extremely essential for the success of any business enterprise. The profit that a society, that a businessman makes doesn't come from a vacuum. It comes from the society he belongs to. Therefore, his commitment, his relationship to that society is not a matter of option, it is mandatory. You cannot lead a successful and happy life amidst an ocean of unsuccessful people living in this area. Society wants your involvement, your support in seeing that society is there, and because society functions, you exist and you make a profit. That kind of awareness is very important. That should go into the part of defining your success. Your success does not take place in a vacuum. Therefore, please do not be carried by the definitions of success and joy handed over by others. Define your own success. You make your own definition of success. That is why all eminent leaders say that think differently. They radiate the fragrance of success. They radiate the fragrance of satisfaction. I think it is such people who are the leaders whom we emulate in our lives, not people without compassion. Nobody emulates people without compassion. There might be wonderful people, but no compassion. Nobody will emulate them. There are wonderful, great people, but no sensitivity. You will detest them. There are wonderful people, but no social responsibility. You will not go to him twice. Don't become like that. Be like flowers. Synthesize all these things and let the fragrance of your personality enrich the world and return. Give the rewards back to the institution which is grooming you. I wish you all the best. I thank fellow Kinship.